Welcome back. Medical advances are being made to help our pets live a longer life, too. Joining us this morning is Dr. Tony Kramer, and you brought Beasley.
Hi,
good morning. Nice to see you again.
Same here.
Beasley is a whopping 16 years old.
She is.
Which is fantastic because she really seems to be a very healthy cat. She's a healthy example, correct?
She sure is, and that's probably the biggest point that we're trying to make by bringing her is she is 16. She's having a wonderful life. She's also diabetic. She's
okay.
been diabetic for 2 years, and she has to get an insulin shot every day. And it's something that we like to tell owners is that these kind of things can be found very early in cats and treated and have them still live their normal lives. But a lot of it's just detecting it at an early age when it can be treated before they get sick from it. And
so there are some things that we're talking about that they should look for, that the pet owners should look for, including, we'll start off with vomiting and diarrhea and things like this.
I mean, some things like that are very obvious that people would know something's mm-hmm. wrong, but other things like just drinking more water, going to the bathroom more often, those kind of things would be something that you'd want to have a veterinarian check out, have a blood test done, have an x-ray done, before they're really ill, but when these first little signs show up, or even when they're normal, to get some baseline blood values so you have something to compare to when they do get sick.
I'm sort of laughing at this last one, exercise intolerance, because so many cats are like Beasley's doing right now, just kind of lounging around, you know.
It's
this
true.
This is exactly how my pets usually are.
Yeah.
How much should you expect a cat? With a dog, you should take them out and walk them at least once a day. Twice, of course, would be great.
Sure.
But with cats, because you don't always have to do that, what should you expect?
Well, I think as they get older, we know they're going to slow down
mm-hmm.
a little bit, that's for sure. But with both cats and dogs, we look for signs of that slowing down, maybe not just being old age, but being things like arthritis. And those are things that nowadays, giving them a little pill for arthritis or things like that can make them feel a lot better each and every day.
Now, we're also talking about weight loss and weight gain. That's something that's pretty big. And we're talking something that's not, you know, over the course of a year or so. We're talking about something maybe over
pretty
weight
quick.
Loss or gain a couple of months?
Many times, yeah.
As a
pet gets older, weight loss may be a big sign of some kind of disease entity. And we want to make sure that if you see that we have it checked out.
And behavioral changes, for example.
Just them not acting themselves. When people come in and say the cat's just not themselves, they're lethargic or listless, aren't eating, those are some key things that we want to look at early so that we can find these disease entities before they become big problems.
Lumps and bumps on the body, anywhere in particular, around the neck, the stomach, where?
Now we just tell people to run their hands over their animal. If they feel something that wasn't there previous, then we should go ahead and have a veterinarian look at that as well.
Okay, last tips. If you have any questions about this or any other pet segment, you can call the number on your screen, 630-325-1231. Dr. Kramer, we appreciate it. Beasley was a perfect guest as well. Thank you so much.
Thanks for having us.
All right. Anita, we'll send it back to you now.